A very good morning, aspirants. Welcome back to our channel, MPSC Easy Learning. And this is Advocate Sabira. In today's lecture, we'll be covering the most important current affairs questions from Jan 2023 to April 2023. That is 4 months. And previously, I have already completed the 2022 most important current affairs questions. I have made a playlist on my channel. The name of the playlist is Rajya Seva 2023. So in order to revise, you all can go watch the entire series of the playlist. This lecture is going to be extremely important for the upcoming Rajya Seva exam. So let's start with it. And before starting with the lecture, my current affair yearbook for the year 2022 and monthly current affair PDFs for the year 2023 are also available. In the previous year, if you see, at least 100 questions have been tackled from my yearbook. If you wish to see the proof, this is the link of our Telegram channel. And if you wish to purchase it and you want to see a sample for the same, you can message us on this number. We will forward you that. And if you see, I have already covered the most important questions from 2022. Most important questions from Jan to April 2023 will be covered today. Padma Awards have already been covered and First Woman in News have been covered. So this is the upcoming lecture series. All of these lectures are extremely important. I would like to say that once again. All of these lectures are extremely important for the upcoming Rajya Seva exam. So please do go watch it and make your notes and study them. The first and the most important news, State Song of Maharashtra. A question on this has already been asked. That is the reason I added this. So what is your, what is important is, what is the name of the song? The name of the song is Jai Jai Maharashtra Madha. Who has written it? A question on this also has been asked. It has been written by Raja Bade. And who it has been sung by whom? It has been sung by Baladir Krishna Rao Sabre, who is also known as Shahir Sabre. So these are certain important points of this news. Next one. A cricketer's statue in Wankhede is going to be set up. So which cricketer? The cricketer's name is none other than Sachin Tendulkar. A statue of Sachin Tendulkar is going to be set up at the Wankhede Stadium. The next news, a bamboo crash barrier has been installed in Maharashtra. So where it has been installed? It has been installed at in Maharashtra, in Vidarbha. And what is the name of the bamboo crash barrier? It is Bahubali. On which highway? It is on the Vani Varora highway. And which type of bamboo is used? It is Bambusa falco. So how you can remember this is, the people who stay at Vidarbha are as strong as Bahubali. So this is the trick by which you can remember it. Another Maharashtra specific news, world's largest Divyang park. Divyang means handicap. So where it is located? It is located at Nagpur. And what is the name of the park? The name of the park is Anubhuti Inclusive Park. And what kinds of facilities are available there? Such as smell garden, hydrotherapy, special unit for mentally challenged children. All of these facilities are going to be available at the world's largest Divyang park, which is located at Nagpur. Next news, Amrit Bharat Station Scheme. So what is this scheme? Under this scheme, various stations are going to have a makeover. So in Maharashtra, if you see, 123 stations have been selected under the Amrit Bharat Scheme, which are going to undergo a makeover. So here what is important, that how many stations from Maharashtra? It is 123. A question on this kind has already been asked in the Bihar Public Service Commission. Next one, the second astronaut from UAE to go to space. What is his name? His name is Sultan Al Nayadi. And if I tell you Rashid Rover, रशीद रोवर बिलोंग्स टू विच कंट्री? इट बिलोंग्स टू यूएई. दिस इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट विच यू नीड टू कीप इन योर माइंड. नेक्स्ट वन, सैंड बैटरी. दिस इज वर्ल्ड्स फर्स्ट इनिशिएटिव ऑफ अ काइंड. दैट सैंड बैटरी हैज बीन इंस्टॉल्ड एट विच प्लेस? इट हैज बीन इंस्टॉल्ड एट फिनलैंड. इन विच टाउन? इट इज कांकांपा टाउन. एंड वॉट इज द यूज ऑफ दिस बैटरी? दिस विल मेक द बिल्डिंग्स एंड पब्लिक सिस्टम्स वॉर्म. सो वेयर इज द वर्ल्ड्स फर्स्ट सैंड बैटरी लोकेटेड? इट इज लोकेटेड इन फिनलैंड. नेक्स्ट न्यूज, India's first green steel brand. What is the name of the brand? The name of the brand is Kalyani Ferrista, and it has been launched by Union Minister Jyotiraditya Scindia. And it has been made by which company? It has been made by a Pune-based company out of renewable resources. That is the reason it is known as green steel brand. The name of the brand is Kalyani Ferrista. Next news, a question on this has already been asked, that where is Rakhi Gari located? So it is located at Haryana. So the world's largest Harappan culture museum, where is this going to start or where is it located? It is located at Rakhi Gari in Haryana. Where is Rakhi Gari in Haryana? Next news is Asia's longest cycle race. So in this race, what is important? What is the start point and what is the end point? So the start point is Srinagar at Bakshi Stadium and the end point is Kanyakumari. So from the top to the bottom. And how many kilometers is it? It is 3,651 kilometers. Here what is important is how many cyclists had taken part? 29 cyclists had taken part, out of which 28 were men and only one. She was a specially abled woman and her name is Geeta Rao. Here a picture also I have put up. So this is Geeta Rao. Total 29 cyclists, out of which 28 are male, one is female, and the one female, she was specially abled. And what is her name? Her name is Geeta Rao. Next news, very important. First female IAS in frontline combat unit. What is her name? Her name is Shaliza Dhami. Here a very basic question will be asked. The question will be, what is the name of the first female IAS in frontline combat unit? Your answer will be Shaliza Dhami. Next news, first Indian American judge in New York court. What is his name? His name is Arun Subramanyam. Churchgate station has been renamed. So what is the name of Churchgate station now? It is Chintaman Rao Deshmukh. And who was Chintaman Rao Deshmukh? He was the first Indian governor of RBI and he has also been a union finance minister. Here I have put up a picture of Churchgate station, which is an old picture. So this, if you see this part, is your if you are from Mumbai, you'll be able to relate to this. So the part which is in the front of Burger King, so this is that part. This is how it looked in earlier days. So the new name of Churchgate station is Chintaman Rao Deshmukh station. Next news, a very important one. Aurangabad and Osmanabad district of Maharashtra have been renamed. So what is the new name of Aurangabad? It is Chhatrapati Sambhaji Nagar. And what is the new name of Osmanabad? It is Dharashiv. These two points are extremely important. Indian Army has organized women's snow cricket at which place? Snow kahan girta hai? Wo hai aapka Jammu and Kashmir. Tourist police stations. So what exactly is tourist police station? This police stations are particularly established for security of tourists. And where it has been established? It has been established at Andhra Pradesh. These two points are important. Next one, important one from Maharashtra perspective. सॉलिड वेस्ट टू हाइड्रोजन गैस प्लांट, वेयर इज इट लोकेटेड? इट इज लोकेटेड एट पुणे. जू फूड डिलीवरी फैसिलिटी, हु हैज स्टार्टेड दिस? इट हैज बीन स्टार्टेड बाय इंडियन रेलवेज. So here they can ask you, a zoo delivery facility has been started by whom? So they will give you options and your right answer will be Indian Railways. Next one, what is the name of world's first 3D printed rocket? The name is Agnilet. Agnilet, and it has been made by Agnikul Cosmos. So here how you can remember is, so to ignite a rocket you will see fire, Agnilet, that is the trick word. To ignite a rocket, when you ignite a rocket you see fire. Fire ko hindi mein hum kya bolte hain? Agni. So that is the reason, Agnilet. And it has been made by whom? It has been made by Agnikul Cosmos. Next one, world's first living heritage university. What is the name of the university? It is Vishwa Bharati University. In which state is it located? It is located in West Bengal. And what is the meaning of living heritage university? It means a university which is still functioning. So that is the meaning of living heritage university. So the world's first living heritage university is Vishwa Bharati University, located at West Bengal. Next news. World's largest hockey stadium, where is it located? It is located at Rourkela. Where is Rourkela? Rourkela is in Odisha. And what is the name of the stadium? The name of the stadium is Birsa Munda Hockey Stadium. And we all know who was Birsa Munda. Birsa Munda was a tribal leader. And it was inaugurated by Chief Minister Naveen Patnaik. And if you see how many seats are there in the stadium, there are 20,011 seats. Next news, the first district to provide basic documents to all tribal people. So which is the district? The district is Wayanad in Kerala. And what is the name of the campaign under which the basic documents were given to the tribal people? The short form is ABCD. And the full form is Akshaya Big Campaign for Document Digitization. This is the full form. Kerala has been in news for some other reason as well. It is that the first constitution literate district in Kerala is Kollam. And recently, Kerala has also launched the world's first scavenging robot. So the name of the robot is Bandicoot, or however you say it. These two news are also important from Kerala perspective. Next news, animal recognized as food animal by FSSAI. What is the meaning of food animal? Food animal means jiska aap meat kha sako. So that will be termed as a food animal. And recently the Himalayan yak has been recognized as a food animal by FSSAI. What is the full form of FSSAI? It is Food Safety and Standards Authority of India. These two points are important. Next news, again very important. India's first dark sky reserve, where is it located? It is located at Ladakh. Ladakh in which region? It is Chanthang region. In Ladakh. So people usually like if you see, they had studied and gone for one of the paper of MPSC, like where is it located? It is located in Ladakh. But in the paper what they asked is, in Ladakh which region? They did not know it is Changthang region. So please keep in your mind, it is Changthang region in Ladakh. And what is the name of the reserve? The name of the reserve is Hanle Dark Sky Reserve. Next one, the first country to import carbon dioxide and bury it under the sea. So the first country is Denmark. The reason why they have planned to bury it under the sea is that the carbon emissions are not let out in the atmosphere, and thus it will lead to reduction in global warming. So this is the major reason why it is going to be buried under the sea. What is strawberry scents? So strawberry scents has been in news. If you see, what is it? It is a star sensor developed by researchers, which will help to find orientations. So this is what strawberry scents is all about. And a question on this has also been asked. It was very basic. Now recently, strawberry scents has been in news. So what exactly is it? Next one, very important. Project Elephant completed 30 years. So, what we need to know is when was the project launched? It was launched in 1992. Why was it launched? It was launched to protect the habitat. Next point, elephant is the national heritage animal of India. And if you see, the maximum elephant population is found in Karnataka. First rank, second rank goes to Assam. And when is World Elephant Day celebrated? It is celebrated on August 12th. And recently, Gaj Utsav has been in news. So here they can ask quiz, Gaj Utsav was inaugurated at which national park? So it is Kaziranga National Park. Where is Kaziranga National Park located? It is located at Assam. And this Utsav was inaugurated by whom? It was inaugurated by President Draupadi Murmu. Next news, again important, Ganga Vilas Cruise. This is the longest river cruise of the world. And where was this inaugurated? It was inaugurated at Varanasi. And in this cruise, they are going to explore 40 historic sites. How many days is the cruise? The cruise is 51 days long. And in that 51 days, they are also going to visit 50 tourist spots. What is the start point and what is the end point? The start point is Varanasi and the end point is Dibrugarh. Where is Dibrugarh? Dibrugarh is in Assam. It will cover 3,200 kilometers in 51 days and it will cross 27 river systems. So these are certain important points which you should keep in your mind. Next one, 74th Republic Day. इससे क्या इम्पॉर्टेंट हो जाता है ये है कि ऑन द 74th रिपब्लिक डे हु वॉज द गेस्ट वॉज अब्दुल अल सीसी हु इज ही इज द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ इजिप्ट एंड दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम एवर इन हिस्ट्री दैट एन इजिप्ट प्रेसिडेंट हैज बीन द चीफ गेस्ट ऑफ द रिपब्लिक डे एंड वॉट इज हिज नेम इज अब्दुल अल सीसी वॉट वॉज द थीम The theme was Jan Bhagidari. And if you see the best tableau, which state won the best tableau, it is Uttarakhand. And what was the tableau based on? You have put up a picture. It was based on wildlife and religious sites. Now what we need to know from Maharashtra perspective is that the Maharashtra tableau was based on what theme? It was based on Nari Shakti and Sade Teen Shakti Pithe. Here what we need to know, what are the names of the Shakti Pithe? It is Kolhapur's Devi Amba, Mahur's Mata Renuka, Vani's Sauta Shrungi Devi and Tuljapur's Bhavani Mata. So this is something which you should keep in your mind. If they ask a question in depth, they can put these points also in your multi-statement questions. And if I have pronounced the name wrong, I'm already sorry for it. Next one, Monument Mitra Scheme. What is the aim of the scheme? The aim of the scheme is to develop heritage sites across India by inviting corporate entities or public sectors. And adopt them. So this is the aim of the Monument Mitra scheme. Why it was in use? The reason is that the scheme was launched by Ministry of Tourism and recently it has been shifted to another ministry. So naya ministry ka naam kya hai? It is the Ministry of Culture. Next one, Nisar satellite. Nisar satellite, first what we need to know is what is the full form of the satellite. The full form is NASA ESRO Synthetic Aperture Radar. That is their full form. Secondly, what is the satellite about? It is an Earth observing satellite. when it will be launched. It will be launched in 2024. And recently a question on NISAR satellite was asked, that NISAR satellite is a collaboration between which two space organizations? Again, very easy if you see NISAR. इससे आपका नासा हो जाता है एंड इससे आपका इसरो हो जाता है. सो दिस इज द कोलैबोरेशन. इट वाज अ कोलैबोरेशन बिटवीन नासा एंड इसरो. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, द लास्ट वन, वेयर इज एशियाज लार्जेस्ट हेलीकॉप्टर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग यूनिट लोकेटेड? इट इज लोकेटेड एट टुमाकुरू. वेयर इज टुमाकुरू? इट इज लोकेटेड इन कर्नाटका. एंड दिस प्लांट और द यूनिट हैज बीन सेटअप बाय हुम? इट हैज बीन सेटअप बाय हिंदुस्तान एरोनॉटिक्स लिमिटेड. आई होप यू ऑल हैव लाइक टुडेज लेक्चर. एंड इफ यू हैव एनी कंस्ट्रक्टिव सजेशन, डिमांड्स और डाउट्स विच यू वॉन्ट अस टू एड्रेस, do let us know in the comment section. We will definitely look into it. Thank you for watching. I hope you all have a great day ahead. Jai Hind.